Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining this live NSO session, Living on Campus, hosted by the Office of Orientation and Transition Programs, University Media Services, and Residence Life and Housing. My name is Kelly Murray, and I serve as the Assistant Director for Orientation and Transition Programs. In this session, our presenters will be providing information about Living on Campus and will give you the opportunity to ask questions. If you have a question during the session, please type your question into the Q&A box, which will be monitored by our staff and Residence Life and Housing staff. For this presentation, we will respond to questions via the Q&A box as we are able, and we will also prompt the presenters with your questions at the end of the session. Now we'll turn it over to Michelle Kane, the Senior Associate Director of Residence Life and Housing.
Hello and welcome. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. I'm always excited to share with our incoming students and their families and friends a little bit about what to expect in our residence halls. So this evening, I'll be going over some of the basics. I'll be providing a few more specifics. And again, I encourage you to do as Kelly asked, toss your questions into the feed there. Supporting me tonight is also Sarah Cummings, who is on our communications team. And Sarah, I'll let you introduce yourself a little bit there too.
Hi, everyone. I will be behind the scenes answering your questions to the best of my ability and also moving the slides around. So
thanks, Sarah. So again, my name is Michelle Kane. My pronouns are she, her, hers. My title is Senior Associate Director in Residence Life and Housing. I've been at the University of Delaware for 23 years in a variety of capacities within our department. It's been an exciting time to see where we've been, where we're growing, how we are constantly adapting to student needs, and certainly how we've been adapting in our current world situation. So we'll get this presentation started without further ado. And again, I encourage you and welcome you to add into your Q&A in there. We really do believe that our experience here in Residence Life and Housing is a chance of a lifetime. I feel that many people this age, you're in our traditional student age group, they're going to grow no matter what. They're going to have new experiences, find differing maturity opportunities. But the chance in the residence halls to do it is a completely unique one. And one of the things that I hold really near and dear to my own heart as I am a professional in the field is really thinking about how to help students grow. And while a lot of my job seems to be about making sure that we have the spaces that we need, I really do feel a true connection to our students and making sure that as they're in that experience, they're finding that growth. And a lot of that happens with our team. So we have a team that consists of over 200 resident assistants in our residence halls. Those RAs are people that are traditionally on a floor with a student. They are an upper division student who's gone through a lot of training to be prepared to help our students through their typical needs in our campus on a daily basis. Our residence hall coordinators are master's level professionals who live in our residence halls in an area overseeing the resident assistants. And what they are doing is providing guidance and addressing some of the larger issues that our students might have. With that group, we also have some graduate assistant hall directors who are current grad students, many of whom have been actually with us previously and also have that investment in our student growth as they pursue their own graduate degrees. We have a number of assistant directors who do a variety of things to oversee and help lead and guide our initiatives in our residence halls, as well as a team of administrative professionals. And those administrative professionals are the folks who are staffing our phones, answering our emails, and really trying to guide and help out our families and our students as they have questions. What I really wanna say is that they truly have a heart for that community that happens in the residence halls. They truly care what's going on. And that community starts with our students. Whether it's our students getting involved, whether it's their own individual needs and their own personal growth about what they're doing. So they're going to help you connect with roommates, with floor mates, with other people in the building. They're going to get you involved in different activities. And I encourage you to go into the Explore Our Halls on our website so you can see a little bit more about other more specific community opportunities we have available. So some things to look out for in terms of those opportunities in our halls. The first floor meeting is gonna typically be held literally that first week of that we are open. Our strengths assessment, this is something that I'm really jazzed about. Strengths is something that many of you might've heard of an organization called Gallup. They do polls, but they also have a whole educational side where they help individuals figure out what they do best and how to apply some of their strengths to their everyday work and reach their goals. And we do a whole programming series around that tool. Community socials are just what they sound like, just really fun opportunities to get to know other students and maybe even learn something about or the rest of our campus as well. Our student initiated programs, that is a hallmark of our department. It is something that we have won national awards for. It is something where we really put the power of opportunity into our students' hands. When I call that power, I really mean helping students guide through developing an event that they find something that they're excited for. So I have to admit, if I were a student, I would be teaching everybody how to do a craft. I enjoy crafting. It is a downtime and it's something that I find a lot of joy and excitement from. And we would provide a student monies to get all the supplies they need to help teach other people those crafts if they wanted to. Other types of student initiated programs that we have are around socials, maybe say like we've got Super Bowl coming up week after we open up, or might be around video game tournaments. It might also be about just doing a fun bake night, celebrating birthdays on the floor. The list is endless. I'll never forget one year I had a student who wanted to do ongoing community and tea and coffee nights. So again, we can provide all sorts of different activities. We just wanna make sure that our students get their voice in those as well. And living in our residence halls, we're excited to have you move in soon. We'll talk about those move-in details pretty soon. And you're gonna be getting information about that opening this week. Later this week, we will provide information on that room assignment. So what building you will live in, the actual room number, and if you have a roommate and or suite mate information in that as well. We encourage you to reach out once you get that information to your future roommate. So in our rooms, and I'm sorry if you've not had an opportunity to do a tour in our buildings, because I know we've been trying to keep our students safe and free from outside visitors, but this is generally what you can expect. We have an extra long twin bed, a desk with a chair. You'll either have a closet with a dresser, or you'll have what's called a wardrobe, which is like a big large unit that has a closet hanging space along with some drawers. In some of our spaces, you also have what we call a nightstand with drawers. Every room has Wi-Fi as well as hardwire internet access, but you don't have to have an Ethernet cord for that purpose. Access to laundry and a shared kitchen in the building. When you get to our room types, though, so what you'll find in there is that our rooms kind of vary. Traditional is what you would think of when people think of what's a residence hall, what's a dorm. It's a hallway with rooms on either side. That's what a traditional is. So a traditional has those two beds typically in there, sometimes three. Again, depends upon the size of the room. And there's shared bathrooms on that floor. In our suite style buildings, that is two rooms connected by a bathroom, shared by the two rooms. That bathroom does not open out to the hallway, so that the people who are in those two rooms are sharing that bathroom. A thing to note is that if you're in a traditional hall where there's a community bathroom, our custodial services is cleaning those bathrooms. If you're in a suite style hall with a private bathroom inside those two rooms area, you're responsible for cleaning those bathrooms on your own. What I want to share with you for a moment is that many of our first year residence halls are represented on our website in a video format. We have these fantastic 3D videos that we were able to get done. And for our returning students, I apologize that you're not seeing them. But what I can tell you is that our Ray Street building and the traditional buildings, they really are pretty similar. So Sarah, if you're able to stop sharing for a moment, I'd like to show them a video. So from our website, this is the picture that we were just seeing. This is the Russell complex. And as you scroll down, you'll see this little area here where you can actually start the tour. I'm gonna go to full screen for a moment there. And as you click on the little circles, you'll see that you maneuver around the room. If I hold and drag, I can see this area of the room. So I can get a kind of a better feel for what it might be like if I'm actually physically in that room and seeing pieces of furniture, et cetera. What I would also like to note, there's this handy dandy little measurement tool. A lot of times we get a question like, how large is a desk? I can click on that measuring tool, start here, click this button here first, sorry. Start at this corner, and then move over to here, as well as come over to here. And then I get that this is 2.5 feet right there. So not all rooms are exact. I do need to let you know that. But it gives you a good idea of what you're looking for in each of our spaces. So we'll transition back and get to moving in. On our move-in day, this is going to be Sunday, February the 6th. We will start at 10 a.m. and we'll end at 6 p.m. We also have a Monday move-in period from 11 to 3. Our classes do start on that Monday day, but we do recognize that some people might not be able to make it. We will have some carts limited availability in our buildings with elevators only. I always highly recommend for people that we don't always know there'll be enough carts for everybody. So make sure, you know, bring a hand truck or something else that might be helpful to getting yourself, getting your items inside. Not all of our buildings have elevators. So be prepared especially if you're not on a first floor. Everybody should have a face covering and complete your health screen check-in for the day. You're gonna go right directly to your building area, and our move-in guide on our website has exactly the location of where you need to go to pick up your key. And for students who have not yet gotten their ID cards, I encourage you to go to the OneCard website. upload your photo so they can get approved and printed. And as long as it is done in a timely fashion, they should be coming to us and we'll be able to hand it out to you. Our staff will be there to welcome you in. You'll go to what's called drop and go lanes. So we ask you to unload your car quickly so you can get moved to full-time parking. Please be sure not to park in our fire lanes because they truly are a fire access lane. It's really important to check your at udel.edu email on a daily basis. We will communicate all sorts of things to you. Again, your room assignment will go there. We will talk to you about, you know, any kind of changes that happen and updates that through there. Our in-house team will send you newsletters on a weekly basis there with all the latest and greatest that are happening in your residence hall. So it's just real important to check those. And like I said, later this week is when we'll be sending you information about your room assignment and about the move-in period. We definitely do welcome you to UD. We're excited. We were so excited to have a full opening and a really robust opening this past fall. We're super excited to welcome students back onto campus this coming spring. And while we certainly have had to navigate the changes of our COVID world and at times reducing the number of students or that in general activities, what I can tell you is that I hear repeatedly from our students that they enjoyed being on campus. They were making connections, and we hope to make that only better this coming spring. I encourage you to screenshot or take a picture, whatever you need to do, of this slide here. We encourage you, we always put our information out about our phone number and about our email. We are still a team who is able to answer our phones and answer our emails. We are here typically most days, Monday through Friday, starting at 8, closing up at 5. We don't answer emails overnight, so please do understand that might take us a little bit to get back to that. But our team does answer our phones. We have had an amazing phone team, stay consistent, and we'll do our best to answer your questions. And then you see that udel.edu/reslife and the contact us. You'll find at the point that you get your assignment, if you want to get more information by your specific residence hall coordinator or graduate assistant hall director, you'll find their contact information there. We do make a suggestion about, you know, questions to ask your roommates. You know, living with somebody can be a challenge all the time. There's no doubt about it. And many of our students are coming to us living away from home for the first time, number one, and oftentimes sharing a room for the first time. Admittedly, I'm the youngest of five. I shared a room my entire life. So going to college and sharing a room was not a surprise to me and was absolutely my norm, but that is not typically the norm. And a lot of times that we have the challenges between roommates, and again, roommate problems happen. I've had the same roommate for over 19 years and I still have problems with that roommate at times. And I love him, dearly. So he knows that, and you have to talk things out. And sometimes we give you a little bit of those prompting, whether it's on our website, some questions that you can ask a potential roommate, and or the idea of working with your resident assistant to help you with those struggles. They might be there to help you role play or might be there to help you facilitate that conversation. And again, we encourage you to explore our buildings. You'll find videos like the one or the tours that I showed you on that website, and you can get some better ideas about our other buildings as well once you get your actual assignment. So that's my speedy presentation, because I've been here for a while, so I know the details, but that's where I'm happy to see what kind of questions I might be able to answer at this time.
So Michelle, I don't recall, one question was about the residence halls for honor students. Obviously I know about Reading for first year students, but I don't recall what they are for upper division. Could you go over those?
Oh yeah, so our upper division honor students could live anywhere on campus. If they choose to stay in what is known as the honors community, this year that community was in Brown and Syford.
Great.
I see a question about if a student contracts COVID. We have been putting out to students that students are expected to return home if they wind up testing positive for COVID. So please know that that is an expectation that students are returning to their homes if they contract the coronavirus. And students do need to test before they arrive here, no more than 48 hours before coming onto campus. So if you don't have your ID, I do recommend that you connect with the Student Health Services. My understanding is that they are also accepting a driver's license. And if the student does not have a driver's license, again, that's where you're gonna wanna connect with our Student Health Services for questions about what might be a more suitable identification marker.
Looks like we worked through all the questions. Does anyone else have questions that we can answer for you?
So you might not have questions about this, but I'd like to put this out there. I know you're just starting to join us in just a short period of time, but it's already time to start thinking about housing for next year. We open up our returning student, which you will all be come February the 6th, because you'll be returning for next year. The application for the 22-23 academic year will open in February in the first week that we are open, and will close promptly on Tuesday, March the 1st at 5 p.m. It is important that you sign up if you're interested in housing, that you sign up at that time, because we won't have a late application opportunity until much later, if at all. While we don't guarantee second or third or fourth year housing for every student, we feel confident in our ability to house everybody who requests. That's been the situation the last couple of years, and I am forecasting that for this coming year. But again, it is not a guarantee that you'll receive housing until after we get in all of our applications. So we start evaluating that literally on March 1st at 5:01 p.m. And then we will get out answers to students to let them know if they've been guaranteed by March 4th. One of the things I know that some students who are incoming find challenging is about selecting a roommate, because at the point that you are signing up for housing, you're also selecting a roommate. Please know that not everybody goes into our process having selected a roommate, and we actually don't guarantee roommates. We do our best though to make sure that roommates stay together. So when you're coming onto campus, you have till that March 1st timeline to change any information. So maybe you make friends fast and furious with a couple of people. You're like, oh, we should totally live together next year. And that's fantastic. And then make sure that everybody has selected each other and applied for that housing by March 1st. And maybe you're finding, I'm not too sure still, it's completely normal to go into the process not having picked someone and then finding somebody that you can connect with later on and see if you can get room together. So again, just a little hint about that. Additionally, when you apply for campus housing, you're applying for a space on campus, not for a particular room or a location. We get a lot of people who do want to live in our apartment style housing, and I understand that. It feels like that little bit more of independence. Unfortunately, it's the only 30% of our housing that's available for returning students is apartment style. So it's more likely that you won't get an apartment than you will. I put that out there not to push people away, but I want to make sure that folks are really realistic in their expectations. And that it doesn't make a difference if you're going to be a junior, senior, whatever. There's no guarantee that you're going to have an apartment in those other years. But the only way that you can get guaranteed in general for housing is to apply when we open up in February. It is not first come, first serve. We give priority to students who are current first year students rising into their second year. We find that those students have the most gains by living on campus in their second year and often do not have as many resources. We also look to give students who are transfer students this semester, who are entering this semester, that same type of priority. After that, it's by class year in terms of getting priority to get guaranteed housing. Because again, as I mentioned, getting housing is not guaranteed for everybody. So please note, we will have additional information that goes out in that first week of February. And we again send that to that @udel.edu email address, and we'll have additional information posted on our website. So I do encourage folks to apply for housing their second year and make sure you do it at that time. We have generous times to get out of that housing contract, but you do need to make sure that you're paying attention to those deadlines if you choose to change your mind later on.
I just, a slight pivot based on the questions. There's a couple of questions about testing and how to upload it, which makes a lot of sense because it's new and confusing to us all. The link that I just shared is a very good resource, because as soon as the university makes an announcement about any sort of expectations around our COVID precautions, it's hosted on that site, and then it'll walk you through step by step. We're happy to answer your questions, but just so you know, that's a great resource to have on hand.
I refer to that resource all the time when people ask me questions. So Kelly, if there's anything else that you'd like to say as we wrap up, I'm happy to stick around though until we actually officially close up.
Yeah, I have a few things. Thank you, Michelle and Sarah. And thank you to all of you for joining us today. Just a couple wrap up things. If you have not signed up for virtual new student orientation yet, please do so by visiting your Blue Hen Home portal. Virtual NSO will be this Friday from 9 a.m. to noon Eastern Standard Time. And again, you can register students and guests in your Blue Hen Home portal. Also, take a look at your UD email to get more information about 1743 Welcome Days. So our office orientation and transition programs hosts a variety of events during the first week of classes to welcome new students and returning students back to campus. So check out the Student Life website for more information. Those events should be posted within the next week or so and also sent directly to your email. If you are interested in attending any other live special interest sessions like this, there's a dining session tomorrow evening. So please make sure to register either through the Canvas course or through the Blue Hen Family Hub. And as always, if you have any questions about virtual new student orientation, please be sure to contact us at otp@udel.edu.
Only because we got one more question, Kelly, I'll take up a little bit more of your airtime. There was a question about air filters that are changed. So that is handled by our facilities, but having communicated with them a lot over lots of things in my time frame, typically those are changed every 6 months in our residence halls. We try to do it when students aren't really around, but sometimes we need to go in during the semester and our staff put out notification about that. But if there's ever a question, if you thought that there was a problem with the air filter or anything, we always encourage our facilities team has been really just trying to do everything possible, make sure they're always keep caught up. But we don't, if we don't know something's wrong, we don't know to address it. So always make sure to send an email to fixit@udel.edu if there's ever a problem with a facility issue in a residence hall, whether that's in the room, in the hallway, on a floor, take ownership, send that note in so that they can address it. And I think that's it. And you are all welcome. Again, thank you to all of you. Please connect with us at any time at reslife-housing@udel.edu or give us a phone call at 302-831-HOME. H-O-M-E is the 4663 at the end. And we welcome you to your new home and we can't wait to see you. Again, communication coming out this week. Please keep an eye on that at udel.edu email.